Hi there. Suppose you make a film of a moving basketball. If the film has a low frame rate, which means that there are not many pictures taken in 1 second, the motion of the ball looks a bit jerky. If you want to see a more fluid motion, you need pictures of the ball taken at shorter time intervals, that is, at a higher frame rate. The shorter the time intervals between the pictures, the more fluid the motion looks. This is because the distance traveled by the ball is a continuous function of time. What does this mean? Well, here is the graph of a function f describing the distance traveled by the ball. You can see that f of 3 equals 2. If we now take a point x on the horizontal axis, which is close to 3, you see that the value of f at x stays close to 2. We say that the function f is continuous at the point 3. The function that you see here is actually continuous at any point p, because if we take a point x which is close to p, then f of x will be close to f of p. In other words, a small change on the horizontal axis will only give a small change on the vertical axis. A function that is continuous at any point p in the domain is called a continuous function. So the function f that you see here is continuous. Not every function is continuous. Suppose you make a film of the balance on your bank account. At a certain point, you see the balance change from, say, 50 to 150. No matter how high the frame rate of your film is, the balance always jumps. The change will never look fluid. If you look at the graph of this function, which is the amount of money on your bank account, you can see that a small change on the horizontal axis from t is 1 to the left will always result in a change on the vertical axis of 100, that is, a large change. This is an example of a discontinuous function. This function, the balance on your bank account, can be described with a piecewise defined function, that is, the function itself is given on different intervals by different formulas. In this case, the function can be given by f of t equals 50 for t less than 1, and f of t equals 150 for t greater or equal to 1. The open dot in the graph indicates that the value of f in 1 is not 50, and the closed dot indicates that it is 150. Another example of a piecewise defined function is the absolute value function, which is defined to be minus x for negative x, and the value is x for non-negative x. Note that the absolute value function is continuous, but piecewise defined functions are often discontinuous, as is the function on the left here. You see that the graph of this discontinuous function makes a jump, so the function skips values in between. For a continuous function, this never happens. To be more precise, a continuous function has the intermediate value property. This says that if f is a continuous function on a closed interval ab, then it attains all values between f of a and f of b. For the graph of f on this interval, it means that you can draw the graph without having to take your pen off the paper. The intermediate value property guarantees, for instance, that the equation x to the power 5 minus x squared plus 1 equals 0 has at least one solution on the interval minus 1, 0, even though we cannot calculate it exactly. This is because the function x to the power 5 minus x squared plus 1 is continuous, and it attains positive and negative values on the interval minus 1, 0, so it must also be 0 at some point. You can clearly see this from the graph. If f is not continuous, the intermediate value property might not hold. For example, if the balance of your bank account goes from 50 to 150, it has not attained any of the values in between. Most of the functions that you've seen so far are continuous functions. For example, polynomials, but also rational functions and power functions, are continuous on every point of their domain. For instance, the function 1 over x is continuous on its domain, which consists of all real numbers except 0. Sometimes this causes confusion because the graph makes a jump at x equals 0, but this is not a point in the domain. If we make a new function out of two continuous functions by adding, multiplying, or dividing them, we get again a continuous function. For example, the square root of x divided by x minus 1 is continuous on its domain, that is, on numbers larger than or equal to zero, except one, because it is the quotient of two continuous functions. Be careful, though, with piecewise defined functions. For example, the function which is equal to x for x less than zero and equal to one for x greater or equal to zero is made of continuous functions, namely the functions x and the constant function 1. But f itself is not continuous because there is a jump at x equals 0. Continuous functions have nice properties, such as the intermediate value property. As we have seen, this plays a role in solving equations. Realize, however, that not every function is continuous. So it is important to be able to see whether a function is continuous or not. You can practice this in the exercises.